here we are standing at the top of the Dock Sandstone. You can see it tilted off to the side and looking down over the Unkar Delta. And the Unkar Delta is an absolutely fantastic place to see, personally, my favorite type of deposits. We're looking at terraces and gravel bars and very young sediments. So everything we've been looking at in the Grand Canyon is hundreds of millions to billions of years old. But here we're looking at deposits that could be as young as yesterday. You're looking at sands and sediments that are actively being deposited still. Most of these deposits that you can see come from one of two sources. They're either coming from the north rim of the canyon, right up to the side, right up there, and you can see there's a little channel that's flowing down, that's Unkar Creek. And Unkar Creek has the ability during really, really heavy floods to carry a lot of sediment down from the northern rim of the canyon, and it would deposit it right down here. The other places could be coming from all these different deposits is the Colorado River itself, back when it was allowed to flow in its original, very dramatic, beautiful, brown, messy, turbulent self before 1963 when the Glen Canyon Dam was built. So all of these deposits are all just gravel, sand, silt, whatever the river is carrying or whatever the creek could carry during the flooding. The Unkar Delta is special because this is one of the prime archaeological sites in the Grand Canyon. This is an area where from around 850 to 1200 AD, the Anasazi people were living and dwelling and farming seasonally as the weather permitted and as the river permitted. And so they lived here for a couple hundred years. It was a hard life. There are estimates that they only lived to about an average of 34 years of age. But this was their home for huge portions of the year until finally around 1200 they disappeared from this region.